In this video, we will try to understand another typical example on Coriolis component of acceleration. So the mechanism is as shown over here. Now in this case, we are having the link PQ. So this is the link PQ, which is free to slide in this slotted trunnion, that is 3. Link 3 is the slotted trunnion, which is shown by this particular circle over here, as well as this particular trunnion is also carried on the another link ST, which is free to move in this particular guides which are shown. So these hatch lines, these are the guides which are shown over here, and in this particular guides this link ST also moves. Now here, as we have already seen, this is the trunnion, the link PQ is sliding over here, and R is the point on this particular link. The link, this is the vertical link, and R1 is the point which is on the trunnion itself, which is connected to this particular link PQ. So we can say that R and R1, they are the coincident points, and the link PQ is rotating in the anticlockwise direction with angular velocity of 30 radian per second as shown over here. So this trunnion, it will swivel over here, and there is a sliding motion of this link PQ which slides inside this particular slot, as well as this trunnion, it will slide over here. So we can say that there is a Coriolis component because there are two coincident points, R and R1. So the R is the point on the vertical link, whereas R1 is the point on this link PQ, and it is on the trunnion itself. So this R is this particular point which is shown over here. Now in this particular case, we know only the fixed point P and the center distance, or this particular distance 300 mm. So the distance between this P and this vertical link ST is 300 mm. So from P, draw a line at a distance of 3 cm by taking space diagram scale. 1 cm is equal to 100 mm over here. Then at an angle of 35 degrees, you have to draw this link PQ of any length over here, such that it will intersect this vertical link ST at this particular point, and then we can measure this particular length. So this PR1, that length we have to measure, multiplied by space diagram scale will give the actual dimension of this particular PR1, which is actually not given in our example. Now let us start with the velocity diagram. We know that velocity of R1 with respect to P. So we are considering this R1 point over here, which is on link 3. Velocity of R1 with respect to fixed point P1 will be perpendicular to the link and in the direction of rotation. Direction of rotation is anticlockwise. So therefore, this is the direction of VR1P. Then the point R, which is on this vertical link, is sliding in this particular trunnion along this particular link PQ. So this is the velocity of sliding of R with respect to R1. As well as there is a sliding motion of this point R along this vertical direction also. So velocity of R with respect to P, or velocity of R with respect to S, or velocity of R with respect to T. All these things represent the same thing because P, S and T, they are the fixed point. Now let us start with the velocity diagram. So our first point, fixed point that we have taken in the space, the fixed points you can take either P, S or T. All of them, they are at the same point. From P, draw a line parallel to this particular vector representing VR1P. Now come to the second vector. This is velocity of RR1. So draw a line parallel to this. Out of this R and R1, point R1 is known. So from R1, draw a faint line showing or indicating that it is, we are representing vector VRR1, but its magnitude and direction, it is not known to us. So this particular vector is not known in magnitude as well as direction, whereas this is known in magnitude as well as direction. Now let us come to the third vector, velocity of r with respect to phi, where p is the fixed point. So out of this r and p, p point is known. So from p, draw a vertical line or a line parallel to this. Wherever these two, they intersect each other, that is our point r. So we can say that this is velocity of sliding r with respect to r1, and this is velocity of r with respect to p. Arrow must be towards the point whose velocity we are finding out. Now there must be Coriolis component of acceleration, because r and r1, they are the coincident points. So as you can see over here, draw a line parallel to this vector r, r1 that we have drawn over here. So the same vector r, r1 is shown over here, and we know that this particular r and this particular r1, r1 is lying on this trunnion, correct, and they are sliding, this particular point is sliding across this particular link. So we have to take into consideration the omega of link PQ, and it is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So rotate this particular vector in anti-clockwise direction, and that will give the Coriolis component of r with respect to r1. So in this way we have calculated the direction of this particular Coriolis component of acceleration. So once again, try to understand, draw this particular vector r, r1 over here, and rotate this vector in anti-clockwise direction, in the same direction as that of the link PQ, which is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So rotate this vector in anti-clockwise direction by 90 degrees, and you will get the direction of Coriolis component of acceleration. Now let's do some velocity calculations over here. Now velocity of r1 with respect to p, that is length pr1, which is 0.366 meter, multiply by 30, that is this particular value. Now suppose we represent this by 3 centimeters. So as you can see over here, this particular length is represented by 3 centimeters. Then the velocity diagram scale will be 10.98 divided by 3, that is 3.66 meter per second. It means that on your velocity diagram, 1 centimeter represents 3.66 meter per second. Now we have obtained the lengths r, r1. So this r, r1 length that we have obtained is 2.1 multiplied by the scale, that is 3.666. So that will give the velocity of sliding, that is r with respect to r1. Similarly, velocity of r with respect to p, or velocity of r with respect to s, or velocity of r with respect to t, and that is given by length 3.66. this is the length PR, correct, and multiply by the velocity diagram scale, that is also 3.66. so the velocity of sliding of the link ST is 13.3956 meter per second. Now we'll do some acceleration diagram calculations over here. So we know that radial acceleration of PQ or R1P is V square upon R, so that we have calculated over here. Similarly, if we represent this particular acceleration by 3 centimeter on our diagram, then acceleration diagram scale will be the 329.4 divided by 3, that is 109.8 meter per second square. Coriolis component of acceleration is given by 2 times velocity of sliding into omega of the link on which it is sliding, so that is 461.16 meter per second square. Now as we have decided to indicate the radial component by 3 centimeter, you can choose any length. So if this radial component of 329.4 is represented by 3 centimeter, then Coriolis component of 461.16 will be represented by how many centimeters by scale. So it is 461.16 into 3 divided by 329.4. so we are going to represent this particular Coriolis component by 4.2 centimeter. Now we know that the radial component is of this R1 with respect to P is directed towards the center. So P is the center, so it is directed towards the center. Coriolis component, we have obtained a direction, so that we have shown over here. Then sliding will be perpendicular to this Coriolis component, whose magnitude and direction we don't know. And then linear acceleration of point R with respect to S or P or T, that will be this particular component. So this is acceleration of R with respect to P. So first start with our radial acceleration. So radial acceleration of R1P is indicated by 3 cm over here. Then Coriolis component is represented by, as we have already said, it will be represented by 4.2 cm. Sliding component magnitude and direction we don't know. So this is the sliding component whose magnitude and direction we don't know, that we have drawn. And then this linear acceleration is drawn over here. So these are the various accelerations. So once again, try to understand. Start with this point P. From P, draw a line parallel to this vector 3 cm. Then from R1, draw a line parallel to this Coriolis component by 4.2 cm. Call this point X. From X, draw a line, that is this particular line, parallel to this sliding component of the acceleration. Then from point P, that is from point P, draw a line parallel to this, that is vertical line over here. So wherever these two, they intersect each other, that is point R, as shown over here. So these are the various values when we actually draw the diagram. So this is indicated by FRP is given by 5.13 cm. Then sliding component is given by 5.94 cm. Coriolis component, already we have decided, by 4.2 cm. This radial component is 3 cm that we have already chosen. And this resultant acceleration is obtained as 7.28 cm. So we can say that the acceleration of the sliding over here for this particular link is given by this FRP, which is obtained as 5.13 cm. So 5.13 multiplied by acceleration diagram scale. So here the value that we have obtained is 5.13 multiplied by acceleration diagram scale, that is 109.8. So finally we'll get this value as 563.274 meter per second square. So in this way we can draw the velocity and acceleration diagram in case of Coriolis component. Thank you very much for watching.